2, and we're here with episode 2, and anyways, let's start it. Yes. No. Because you know me. Okay, hold up. So let's go forward. Yes, this is younger Sal with short luscious locks. Blue luscious locks. Diane Fisher. Don't wander so far, sweetie. I want to see the doggy, Mom. Can't you hear him? Why don't you wait for your father? Until your father gets here, okay? He should be here any minute now. But I really want to see it. Please? Please, can I go pet the doggy? Oh. Alright, Sal. Just give me a second to get my purse. Then we can go together. Yay! I'll wait over there by the trees. Thanks, Savvy. You don't have to, like, so hyped up. Yes, this is right before his face got destroyed. Oh, ho, ho. The doggy. His face is completely bleeding. Oh my god. Look at his face. He was shot in the He was shot in the right eye. Even though it shows both eyes in the actual game. For some reason. Bloodline. Bones. Hey, what?
Have you seen any,
Okay. Let's enter. Oh! Whoa. Thank you for so much for coming to help out with the toilet. The problem is with Sanderson. I'll have it unclogged in no time. Wonderful. Herman normally would have taken care of himself, but unfortunately, his fingers have turned into a banana peels. And the street corner is just so dangerous. I understand. What? They take poos on the side of the road. I mean, it's not surprising because it's the 80s. Thank you so much, Larry. Larry? Excuse me? Larry? The bathroom is just over there. Why is it sideways? Oh, scary. Oh, who's knocking on the window? Ah, Pony. You there. Please help me. What's wrong? The water. It stopped. So thirsty. Don't worry, I know how to fix this. Please. Hurry. My voice. Bro, they put his Jacksepticeye eye. They put his Jacksepticeye eye right there in the sewer drain right there. Oh my god. They put a Jacksepticeye eye. Ooh. Strange. Wrong one. Okay, I'm guessing it's the middle, bottom, top. Or middle, top, bottom. Yeah, probably the middle, top, bottom. Okay, middle, top. Wrong way. Top? Yes. Now bottom. Oh, wrong way. It worked. Nice clean water. Ew! 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 That's disgusting. Ha! Booty cheeks! It has booty cheeks! Disgusting. We get a fisheye perspective. Heck yes. Sal, come closer. I have something to show you. I know you touched my pony. I thought we were friends, Sal.
Oh my god.
He looks cool without his mask. He looks absolutely cool without his mask. I love it. Episode 2, The Wretched. Oh, that hurts my ears. Man, you're still having those nightmares? I haven't had them this bad since right after my mom died. I really think it's this building. There's something off about it. Dude, I know you're so insistent about it, but I really don't think this place is haunted. I've been here for most of my life and haven't seen any ghosts, but what? Well, we've known each other for a while now. I have to show you something. Okay, let's go. Creeper. Aw, man. Ready? He has a red freaking. So cute! Whoa. How come you never told me about this? It's where I go when I need to be alone. It's my fortress of solitude. Awesome. so cool. I always wanted a treehouse when I was younger. Yeah, my dad built this for me before he disappeared. Wait, what? What do you mean disappeared? One day he was here and everything was okay, and then the next day he was just gone. No note, no nothing. And all of these things were still here. His clothes, his tools, his wallet, his driver's license, everything. He just disappeared. Damn. I'm so sorry, Larry. I know it's how hard that is. Did your parents not get along? No, my parents loved each other. They hardly even fought or anything. It isn't what it sounds like. My dad didn't leave us. Even if that's what my mom chooses to believe, I know he wouldn't ever leave us like that. He loved us. I believe you. So, what do you think happened? Look, you know I'm not generally superstitious. And I know you and Chug swear that the apartments are haunted, but, well, I think it's something else. Like what? I haven't told many people about this, but I know I can trust you, Sal. I know you won't judge me. Of course not. The day before he disappeared, I did something I'm not too proud of. My parents got some firecrackers and they told me so many times to wait for them, not to play with them on my own, but I just couldn't resist it. I lit a few out back and one ended up in Mrs. Gibson's open window. It killed her pet rabbit. Oh man, that's rough. Dude, I know, man. He listens to metal. He's my favorite character in the whole entire game. Him and Sal. Oh man, that's rough. I know, I already read it. Yeah, so I ran to check on Mrs. Gibson, and she was screaming at me like crazy. As if I needed another reason to piss off that old bag. I felt horrible though. That poor bunny. Anyway, I was coming down in the elevator and that's when I saw the demon. He reached out and touched me. I got this super cold chill down my whole body. I was scared shitless, dude. I thought I was losing my mind. He was gone as quick as he came, just as the doors opened. He cursed me because of what I did. He cursed me. Everything in my life was after that. My dad disappeared. My mom stopped talking for a while. I had to spend 2 weeks in juvie for accidentally killing that rabbit. My bike got stolen. I missed so much school that I had to take summer classes. It's been one bad thing after the next. Ever since then, horrible things have happened to me or around me. So you think this church called you took your dad away? I know how it sounds, but I know it's true. It's all my fault. My dad, the rabbit, Mrs. Sanderson, everything. Whoa, hold on. Man, even if there is some kind of curse on you, you can't blame yourself for every bad thing that happens. It's not all your fault. What did this demon look like? It was nothing like I've seen before. It was like a moving shadow. All black and missing, but had the form of a man. And the eyes were the worst part. These deep red eyes that pierce right through you. Holy shit. What? I think I've seen it too. I've seen your demon. No way. When? I swear I've seen it in the building. Just like you described. I bet it's linked to the other ghosts too. I don't know, dude. What if we break this curse of yours? How would we do that? Maybe there are some clues around that could help. We can try to find out more about the ghost. See if we can get to the bottom of this. Sure, why not? I've got nothing to lose. I'm gonna look. Huh, that's strange. What is that? I found this weird gearboard cartridge in the lost and found box a while ago. I think it reacts to supernatural activity. That was one of the last pictures we took together, not long before he disappeared. I better keep looking. His mom had curly hair. What? A bunch of nature and outdoorsy magazines. Seems like Larry's dad is the opposite of my dad. The magazines are all old, from 6 years ago or more. It doesn't look like anything too useful, though. Let's see what else is in here. A worn leather jacket. There are a couple old concert tickets in the pocket. I guess that's where Larry gets his taste in music. Seems like a nice way to bond. I don't think I've even watched a concert on TV with my dad. Let alone go to one live. There's some kind of weird small box in here. Looks like it's sealed shut. What's in the box? What's in the box? What's in the box? I have no idea, man. It belonged to my dad. It's some kind of puzzle box. I never could figure out how to open it, though. Looks like there's a piece missing. Oh, yeah, you're right. I never noticed that before. So, do you mind if I hold on to this? Nah, go ahead. Cool. Just let me know if you get it open. Of course. Let's leave. Because... Alright, let's walk with Larry. Oh my god, I love how it... Sal's little head bobbles when he talks. Just so cute. Okay. I'm gonna look around and see what else I can find out. Okay, sounds good. I sort of have to stay here and take care of my mom. She's super sick. Yeah, I noticed that. Well, let me know if there's anything you need. Thanks, Sally. Ooh. The painting looks super strange. I should ask Megan if she knows anything about this demon. I hope she'll come out today. Megan? Who is Megan? Who is Megan? No. Larry's mom. Hey, Lisa. Feeling any better today? Oh, hiya, Sal. I think that they might be the worst of it. Once I'm over this hump, I'll be bright as rain. Which is good, because there's so much work to be done. I'm just itching to get back to it. Take it easy for now and get some rest. Oh, don't you worry about me, Sal. I've been resting plenty. Larry has been so helpful, too. I'll be just fine. Can I get you anything? Don't trouble yourself any, Sal. Larry is taking good care of me. nothing in the bathroom anymore. I'm gonna go to, here's Chug. Chug, what are you up to? Hi, Jellyfish. I'm waiting for the snack guy to fill the machine. Can't start my Saturday without chocolate. I hear ya. I like to start the weekend off with video games and cartoons. Did you see the new Rico's Modest Wife episode? Yeah, that was great. I love that show. Me too. Anyway, I'm gonna go to up to 5 to see if Megan is there. If not, I'll just go to Megan on 5 out of 4. I should call Larry up here so we can meet Megan. He'll have to believe that. I just want our apartments are haunted. Larry, you there? I'm here. What's up? Can you come up to 504? Sure, my mom just took her medicine, so she'll be passed out for a while. Anyways, I'll be right up. So, what is it you wanted to show me? Come on, she's in the bathroom. She? Just come on. Damn, these fifth floor rooms have seen better days. Shh. What? Just wait a minute. Megan, are you here? Hello? I want you to meet my friend, Larry. I don't think there's anything in here, dude. She might be afraid. She can be pretty shy, though. I haven't been able to get her to come out in a while now. I hope she's okay. So you come up to this moldy bathroom to talk to a dead girl? How often do you come up here? I've been able to talk to her a few times, but like I said, she hasn't been around lately. I'm not crazy, Larry. I'm going to prove this to you. Hey, I never said you were crazy, man. As weird as this is, I believe you, okay? You're my best bud. And if this helps at all with finding my dad, then I'm all for it. I really thought we'd be able to talk to her today. I just had this feeling. Dude, you know who you should go talk with? Todd. He's probably the smartest kid I know. And he's also into this supernatural stuff like you are. I bet he could help somehow. Todd? Really? Huh. I never expected that he would believe in that stuff. He always seems so normal, rational. Yeah, I guess so. Okay, well, I'll go talk to him and see what I can find out. Alright, I'm gonna head back downstairs to make sure my mom's alright. Let me know if you find anything. Will do. Sally face. Larry face. Don't worry about the yelling. That's just one of my siblings or my parents. Yeah, let's go. Locked. I didn't press it. Okay, let's go to 202. Hey, Sally Face. Sorry, it took me a minute to answer. I was wrapping up the tutoring lesson with Ashley. Have you two met? Hey, I'm Ash. crush. You must be Sally Fish. I've heard so much about you. Me? You have? Yeah, all good things, I swear. I'm glad I finally got to meet you. Me too. You too. I mean, it's nice to meet you as well. Well, I'd love to stay and chat more, but I have to get going. Thanks for helping me out today, Todd. No problem. We can work more algebra next week. Sounds good. I'll see you guys later. Hopefully I'll run into you again soon, Sally Face. Yeah, that'd be awesome. Enjoy the weekend, boys. You too. You alright, son? You seem so anxious. Oh, yeah, I'm good. I'm cool. So, what brings you this way? Ashton is nice. Is she a person you too? What is she like? Her full name is Ashton Campbell. She's a freshman, like us. An overall nice person. She has some trouble with math, so I've been tutoring her for the past couple of weeks. In exchange, she occasionally assists me with my art assignments. She sounds like a great friend. Sure, I suppose so. You didn't come here to talk about Ashley, though, so what's up? Oh, right. I see dead people. Are you referring to Mrs. Sanderson? No, it's something else. This building is haunted, and I'm trying to find out more about the ghosts here. I see. I need your help. Thank you for telling me your story. I think I may be of some assistance to you with your exploration of the paranormal. Specifically, I have a suspicion that an apparition resides in my bathroom. Huh? Really? Yes, it does seem to be a strange coincidence that you're making in my apparition. I both found in bathrooms. However, it could also be that the water pipes act as some sort of conductor for you. That is only speculation on my part. Do you have the Gear Boy cartridge for you now? Yeah. Perfect. Let's go check out the bathroom. What do you usually do to call upon Megan? Did the Gear Boy always light up when she's near? It doesn't light up every time. Usually I just start talking to her. Sometimes she comes out, sometimes she doesn't. Okay, go ahead and try the same thing here so we can attend to some of the spirit. Hello? Is anyone here with us? We're not going to hurt you. We're your friends. Hello? Is anyone there? Nothing is happening, and the game isn't lining up either. I have an idea. Let me see that. I bet I can modify your Gear Boy to help better detect supernatural hotspots. Cool, sounds good to me. I'll need two things in order to complete the alteration. First, I'll need something to amplify the device's reception. And second, something to boost its electrical output. So, like an antenna and a battery pack? Sure, I'll be in my room once you're ready. Weed. Bob. I'm not gonna talk about Bob right now. Coffee, it's the battery for me. Walkie-talkie will work perfectly. Good thinking, Sally Face. I'll be right back. I'm going down to the basement to see if I can get an antenna from Larry. Larry Face. It's Larry Face. I'm almost down to the Larry Face's floor. Okay, not talk to Chug. I'm gonna just take the antenna and leave Larry's house. I hate that painting because that is creepy as heck. Okay. Hasta la vista, Sally. Hey, mind if I borrow the antenna from your scanner? I guess that'd be okay. Your mom okay? Yeah, she'll be alright. Change of scenes is always good to her. It's just a bad cold. She'll be okay. I'll be back. Hasta la vista, Sally. What does hasta la vista mean? I forgot. Yeah, I forgot. Cough. Good toddler. Yes, this will work perfectly. The two components you retrieved in my own equipment, I can adequately make the modifications to your Gear Boy. I spoke up earlier. Give me a moment to get it ready. Okay, all set. Behold the Super Gear Boy. Cool. Don't worry, you can still play games on it. And only be in Ghost Hunting Mode while the strange cartridges. Oh, awesome. You had me worried for a second. However, unfortunately, I needed a few extra parts from your walkie-talkie and wasn't able to salvage it. I hope that's alright. Ed's not gonna be so happy about that. It's okay, though. It's for a good cause. Wonderful. Now, for the best results, you'll need to hold the sister mount with the antenna fully extended. To do so, press the triangle button. The screen will glow if it detects any paranormal frequencies in close proximity. While it's flashing, press that R1 button there to produce a large electrical discharge. If my theory is correct, then the search of electricity will provide an ample source of power to energize near apparitions and possibly other supernatural elements as well. Okay, I think I get the gist of it. I suggest we take it for a test run in my bathroom. Sounds good. Whenever you're ready, hold up the Super Gear Boy by pressing the triangle button. Oh my god. His parents are getting high. If you don't hear the coughs, just listen closely. It worked! Holy crap. Hello? What's the matter?
I never thought he'd killed him. It's all my fault.
Who?
Stacy and her daughter. Oh god, what a fool I was to fall for a married woman.
It's never a crime to follow your heart.
You must be a romantic like I was. It's kind of you to say, but I know better than that.
We want to help you. Why haven't you left this place?
We can never leave.
What do you mean? You can't pass on? What's keeping you here? Have you seen a demon with the red eyes? Can you tell us anything?
No.
What is it?
He's here.
Who, the red-eyed man? The one who killed Stacy and her daughter?
I have to go. I'm sorry.
That was a fully formed and conscious apparition. I'd never seen anything like that. You okay?
Yeah. That's fine.
It's just one thing to read about the paranormal and formulate theories, and a whole other thing to actually experience it. I know what you mean. It's a lot to take in. Well, we have some work to do. I've had my feel of excitement for today. So I'll stay here and do some research. I want to look into the history of Addison Apartments and see if I can find anything about past residents and about the supposed murderers. That'd be really helpful. While you do that, I'm going to search for more supernatural hotspots. Perfect. Oh, and by the way, I noticed some extra static around my game touches. You might want to check it out to make sure it's okay. Let's not be in here. And they were, of course, getting high. Of course they were getting high. They're Todd's parents. They have weed. Stupid fly. I'm trying to find any records relating to the Addison Apartments. I'll probably need to hack into the police database as well. So this could take some time. Check back in later. Oh my god, they're getting high. They're getting freaking high. Doesn't look like anything I can use right now. Really? Who keeps leaving their clothes in here? Oh yeah, there's a picture of me, Lyrians, and Lisa up there. Yay, family. And their consciousness, just check out the super gear board. Todd made that? That's pretty awesome. Like, wait, is that my walkie-talkie? Oh yeah, you need the parts for the upgrade. I hope you don't mind. Can give us new ones. Damn. Well, that's okay. Hopefully it will help to find out more about these ghosts and my curse. Agreed. Hasta la vista, Sally. Let's go up to the 5th floor to see if I can find anything suspicious, because everything seems to happen. Let's go down to 1 and see Mrs. Rosenberg. Who is it? It's Sal from upstairs.
Is there something you want?
I just wanted to talk to you. To me?
To me? Oh, alright. Come on in there. Look, the door is open. Hello there, Sally. What brings a young girl like yourself to see this old woman?
Sal is a boy. Sal is a frickin' boy. You little butthole.
Hi, Miss Rosenberg. I wanted to ask you a few things, if that's okay.
Ask away, child. I mean, not have much left, but time is all I've got now. Yes, time's all I have, and even that'll soon slip away from me. Or maybe I've never really had a grasp on it all. Such a strange concept, isn't it? Time, sitting here alone. The mind can drift a great deal, wondering what's beyond the veil. Get too deep into these thoughts and the world makes less and less sense. Yes, time is an enigma. Oh, but listen to me rambling on, dear. I'm sorry, dear. Sally, do you had something to ask?
How long have you lived here?
Long indeed. Though it's hard to say exactly. My own mind can barely hold on to memories of yesterday anymore. Let alone the distant past. I'm afraid my days are nearing an end. Soon I will return to dust and my consciousness will merge with the great and mysterious nothing. A void that is possible for our little brains.
Whatever.
I tried, yes, a powerful, dreaded, a bit empty nothingness. Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie. I've been rambling on again. What was your question?
It's okay, Mr. Rosenberg. I was asking how long you lived in Addison's apartments.
You know, I do remember when the Addisons moved here from overseas to construct this building. Actually, this land belonged to my family first, but I decided to sell the Addisons since I was the only thing one remaining. I thought the company would be nice to have again. Someone to share the anguish of life with. I was young and desperate for a new beginning. What a foolish girl I was.
You regret selling the land?
A life as old as mine is filled with regret, my dear. Though it all eventually becomes meaningless.
About the Addisons. Whatever happened to the rest of the family? Did they live around town?
They're gone.
Gone?
Time takes us all, Sally. Poor little Terrence. He's the last of his family. Oh, I suppose he's not so little now. But that's how I see him. As young as that boy with a twinkle in his eye and a head filled with dreams. Now look at him. He never leaves that godforsaken room.
Yeah, why does he stay locked away in there?
He went a little kooky as during his family passed. If you ask me, the boy was so wound up he was afraid of his own shadow. Terrence worshipped his father and gave up on his dream of opening a tea house in order to run his father's apartment. Slowly but surely, he began confining himself in the safety of his room until one day he stopped coming out altogether. Yes, despite the tearful persona he puts forth from behind the door of his tent, Addison is about as timid as they come. Damaged by a life of misfortunes,
Little Miss Fortunes.
But aren't we all, my dear? Yes, I suppose we are.
Have you ever seen any ghosts in the building?
Ghosts? Why in heavens would you worry about such a thing as ghosts? Sally, you're a sweet young girl, boy. You remind me of myself from a younger, another time. Do old Rose a favor. Enjoy your life while it lasts. Don't be consumed by the allure of death and its many secrets. I know, yes. It's quite tempting and very easy to get pulled in. But why, you could say, we are all ghosts, really. Just waiting to pass from this place to the next. Such a thin membrane that separates from existence and non-existence. With our frail bones and delicate casings, any small misstep could send us reeling into eternity in the blink of an eye. See ya. Oh my, what is that horrific device you have?
It's a... it's sort of hard to explain.
You really shouldn't tamper with things you don't understand.
I'm gonna leave. Go back up to two, sir. So I can see Todd again. Two oh two.
Strange, but I can't find any reports of past murders. The only one that comes up is our friend Charlie, but look at this photo of him on the public record.
Looker murder receives life sentence. Mug shot Charlie Mansfield, age 41 above. It gets even weirder. There's no trace of any of the officers that were here the day Mrs. Sanderson was killed. Not even in the classified police reports. It's as if they weren't here at all. Or, like, they don't even exist.
How is that possible?
I'm not sure, but I'm going to keep looking into things. Check back in a little while. Okay, I'm gonna keep searching for more supernatural stuff in the meantime. Perfect.
Thank you.
What was that? Excuse me? Excuse me? I'm not sure if anyone is up in 3. But I'll have to check. David.
Hi, Sal. What you up to today?
Hey, David. Have you ever seen any ghosts around?
Yeah, for sure. The ghosts of my past keep me awake at night. All the time. I barely get any sleep around here.
What about, like, a spirit of someone that used to live here?
Sally, he's gotta lay off the drugs, man. Sally doesn't take drugs. I'm telling you, David, shut up. He does not take drugs whatsoever.
Trust me, you'll have a better life for it.
Don't make the same mistakes I did.
What happened to your pants?
Oh, well, they're in the wharf. The wharf still. Sarah was supposed to go get them. But we just got to talking. Not, you know, lost track of time.
See you.
See you.
Pretty busy right now, probably shouldn't bother them.
Chug is plays, Chug is downstairs, and parents work on the weekends. Desk.
Down the B.
I'll be right back.
Alright, I'm back. Let's check out my place. Or, the fourth floor. Yas, queen. Ah, dang it. I don't think anyone lives here. Maybe they left after what happened next door. Pretty much. Oh, look at this. What you watching, buddy? Wow. Okay. Cat turds. Nah. Oh, heck yes. His guitar. Dead. Can't talk right now, so I have to make this deadline for work. Okay, what supernatural hotspots should I look for? There is no supernatural hotspots. Where are the supernatural hotspots? Bro. Ooh, rabbit. Not rabbit, Robert. He must not be home. I don't know where else to go, honestly. We've been on for an hour, yay! Yay! Thank you. Hello, and welcome to my stream. Let's see. I think if you get on, you would kill me if I bother her again. There's a new person on the stream. Anything okay? I haven't been in a long time. I meant, yes, I know, Sally. I'm not gonna drop dead on you. Not today, at least. Todd has found anything about y'all stop getting high in there. What? Not on here.
Thank you.
delicious. Very delicious. Devour. Thank you. Agent Johnson?
No.
Run. No. Don't. That. No cell. Not. Ever. Any. Lives. Till. Saying. Whatever that was. My life is weird. I should probably go check in with Todd again and see if he's found anything. Finally, I found something. Something interesting. It's a missing person case from 1987. Huh? Megan Holmes, age 7, lives in Addison Apartments with her parents, Luke and Stacy. It looks like it may be our little friend from Epstein. It says, she must be the daughter that Greg from my bathroom was telling us about. The stories line up, right? Well, here's where it gets weird again. There's an update to the report one day after the original was filed, stating that the girl was found dead in Wendigo Lake, a few miles south from here, along with her parents. Said they had been fishing before into the river and drowned. Some kind of mudslide or something. That's definitely her. Wait a second. I've seen that necklace before. I know I have. She's never wearing it when I talked to her, but I've seen her it somewhere else. Since you haven't been able to summon her, even with the super gear boy, perhaps finding that necklace will somehow. That actually makes a lot of sense. It's something she had a connection to when she was alive. Now I just need to remember where the hell I saw that thing. It's Stop getting high, guys. Please. Savvy, you still there? You there? That's square. X. I knew I saw that necklace somewhere. Oh, Larry will see Megan for sure. Megan. Movie. Okay, work your magic whenever you're ready. Megan, are you here with us? This is my friend Larry. We have some questions to ask you.
Hi, Sally Face.
Holy knuckles. That's not a nice word, Larry. You'll have to forgive him, Megan. He's never seen a ghost before. It's okay, my daddy says bad words sometimes, too. Where have you been lately? What do you mean? I've been here the whole time. I've been trying to reach you.
I think when you're alive, you can't see the other side.
The other side?
Yeah, that's where we all live. It's just like this side, but a little different.
Do you know someone named Greg?
Oh, you mean Mommy's friend. I like Greg. He always brings me candy.
Can you remember anything else about him?
Just like that he was nice and always brought candy. Oh, and my dad didn't like him so much. But I don't know why.
What can you tell me about your parents?
I miss my mommy. She doesn't talk anymore.
What about your dad?
Daddy scares me now. He scares everyone here. But he wasn't always like that. He used to be nice like Mommy.
What happened?
I remember they had a fight and then he was sad. Then his sadness turned into angriness.
Do you remember your last days?
I don't know. It's all blurry now.
Were you fishing at Lake Wendigo?
Huh? No. I never been fishing before. But my daddy went sometime with Mrs. Johnson.
Wait, Jim Johnson?
Yeah, how did you know that?
That's my dad.
Oh, I guess our daddies were friends.
Can you tell me where he is? Do you know anything else about him? Please, I need to know.
I'm sorry you lost your daddy. I don't know where he is. I just know Mr. Johnson and my daddy went fishing a lot. I'm sorry.
Is this your necklace?
Hey, yes. Where did you find that?
It was downstairs in the bottom of the lost and found box.
My mommy gave me that necklace. She was scared. She said it would protect me from the evil in the world.
Do you know where your mommy is now?
She's in her bedroom, but she never listens to me anymore. I don't think she can hear me.
Do you think she...
Uh-oh!
What?
Daddy's coming. He doesn't like when I talk to people. I have to go. Bye-bye.
Wait, Shit. Yeah, they never seem to circle around long enough. Well, we're going to need to get into that bedroom. It's all boarded up. Can you get some tools for us? Actually, my David borrowed my mom's crowbar and never gave it back. Would you mind going and getting it from him?
I've asked him like 3 times now, and he's always had some excuse. Maybe you'll have better luck. Sure, I'll head down to the 3rd floor now and see what I can do.
Sup, brother?
Can I borrow your crowbar?
I'd love to lend it to you, but it's the only thing holding up my shelf right now. See, those kids next door in 301, they're nice kids and all, but they have these real loud parties sometimes. It shakes the whole wall and my shelf falls right down. If Jens could talk to them for sure for me, get them a little quieter, then I could let Jens borrow the crowbar.
Okay, I can talk to them.
Thanks, Sal. I do it myself, but I'm out of clean clothes. You see, and I just hate to be the old potty pooper, you know?
It's not a problem. I'll be right back.
See you. Yo, what up, Sal?
Hey, CJ, what do you have to?
I'm trying to choose music for the party for our party tonight. Mind if I have a look? Go for it, little dude. No.
How about this? Dude, I think this would put everyone to sleep. How about this? You know, there's something interesting about this one. It's unexpected. It's classy. I think this could work. Hey, Sierra, what are you up to?
Oh, hey, Sally Face. I'm contemplating on an alternate activity for tonight's party. My friends and I usually like to do our own thing, but I'm having trouble narrowing it down. Is it okay if I look over your list?
Sure.
D&D, movie night, Chester.
How about this?
It's been a while since we've done a tournament. That's a perfect choice for tonight.
Hey Z, what's up?
Hey Sally Face, I'm trying to choose a game for the party tonight. I've got this little book of games, but I don't know. Can I take a look? Be my guest.
How about this game?
You know, this reminds me of grade school. That touch of nostalgia could be just what this party needs. Thanks, Sal.
That does it. Their body should be much quieter now.
Sup, brother? Can I borrow your crowbar? I worked it out. It all out with the college students. They're going to have a much more low-key party this time.
Wow, that's great news. Thanks for helping me out.
Sarah will be so happy to.
Last time my blood pressure almost blowed up to pieces. I'm glad I could help.
Right. Let me get that crowbar for you.
1 second.
He's a good buddy. Take care. Thanks, you too.
That's the most weirdest. Dang it. Retrieve the book. Andrews, will you not see my work now? The council recognizes the great resolve you've shown us today. Let this book stand as testament of your place among your ricks from henceforth. May our sight pierce the heavens and our reach be infinite and everlasting. For we are the devourers of God. Oh. Thomas, are you okay?
Who are you?
Pardon my rudeness, ma'am. My name is Gregory Montoya. I didn't mean to intrude on you. It's just that I heard crying and wanted to make sure everything was okay. That's kind of you. I take it you're not with the men of this church. No, ma'am. It's for the best. It's terrible what goes on in this place. It keeps me up at night. I'm beginning to fear for mine and my daughter's safety. I've tried to reason with them. I've reached my wit's end. I understand. I lost my family last year in the big factory fire. It breaks my heart to see a kind lady such as yourself so broken up. I'd like to help however I can. You just tell me what you need. That's awful kind of you, Mr. Moscow. I'm dearly sorry about your family. Please call me Greg. Pleasure to meet you, Greg. I'm Stacy Holmes. You couldn't have come along at a better time. You must be an angel. Just a humble farmer that's glad to be helpful to a nice folk like you. The pleasure is all mine.
Put the power in Greg disposed of the mountains.
Good, and I've destroyed the seventh book. Will we really be able to stop them?
We've got a good chance. Nothing is guaranteed, but I think we might have done it. I should have never let things get this far in the first place. I'm sorry that Luke had to get your family involved in all this. If we can stop the ritual, then the council will have another chance to form it for 1,000 years. Then I pray to God that this works. God doesn't care about us, my dear. Don't waste your breath on such things. We must fight for our own survival.
Yeah. Find that big tree again. Down.
Yeah.
Down.
What? No. What? No. Go. Okay. I know it's in Spanish. I can't read it anyway. Start it. I know where to go. For this. Three times. Right. And down. Down.
Hold on a second. Stop right there.
Just... Oh, you just paused it.
Okay, it's a big tree.
One, two, three, then down, yeah, and then down again.
So go down again. Oh no, you're right there.
Down again.
So go down.
Down again.
That way. Tree again. Stop. Down.
Now where? Right
there. The left.
Now where?
Hold on.
Right there. No. Yeah.
Down.
Down.
Oh wait, there.
Nowhere. Right.
That should be it. Yep, there you go.
Thank you. Where have you been, child? You had me worried sick. I'm sorry, Mama. I was lost and it was so dark and hush now, my sweet angel. Everything is okay. Here, I want you to have this. Grandma's necklace? It will protect you from the wickedness in this world. So you don't have to be afraid anymore. What about Father? He doesn't have to know. This will be our little secret. A young occultist found herself tangled in the bowels of the castle, searching for the final components of the council required. What? Okay. Now where?
Up still.
Okay. Found one. Now where?
That way.
This way? Oh, dang it. Up. No.
Did you hit something?
Yeah. You can't hit those. If you hit them, you die. And yes, this is linked with the cult. Be careful, gotta be swift. Be careful and swift at the same
time.
It's already there. I can't grab it. That was where I started from. Did he used to have a Super Game Boy? Oh, I mean Game Boy. How fun was it? Oh, what games did you? What? Okay.
Alright. Go up.
Okay.
To your left. Now walk the upper wall. And do as tough as you go. Stop. Hold on a second.
Oh, dang it. Hold up. I need to do it again. Now what? Okay. Be careful. What are you doing?
Walk through the wall. Check it out.
What?
See if it's that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Watch.
Oh, it's right there. Right there. Maybe. Somewhere around there. Huh. That's weird. Go up? No, up. Ah, dang it. Okay, I got that one. There, I just teleported them. I don't know where else they would have gone. Dang it. Like five? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're good. Preparations are now complete. Stay within the circle while we perform the summoning. No! I understand. Ah! He found him from somewhere else, even though Luke wasn't sure how he ended up there. He knew what must have been. The woman is a threat to us. She cannot be trusted. We will accomplish great things together and cannot afford any obstacles. Oh God! It's so fast. Oh my God. Please, no. Aha! The child will only slow us down. She will never follow us with her mother's treacherous blood running through her veins. Oh my God. Oh my God. You have to start all the way from the freaking beginning?
No.
Oh. Hold one sec. You just have to go a little. What? Okay. Okay. Walk with me into the undying flame, and our power shall be endless. Can you hear me? Oh my God. Luke? I'm online. Alright, part two. Hold up, I'm trying to pause it. He's not gay. They're not gay. They're brothers. Leave me alone. I can't pause it. Unfortunately, I have to end it there. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye, guys.